I know that you'll go.
Hi guys, how are you? This is Pamela and I am 32 years old. I am from Venezuela. And for the ones that don't know me, if you want to check a little bit more about my story, why I decided to start this channel, you can check out my previous video. And well, I would like to continue with the topic of today that, like I always say, with all my love, I prepare for you. And today it's going to be about Christian Grey analysis, okay? And why this character is so unhealthy, or how can you call it like abusive man? You know, he has many of the traits that many abusive men have, that he's really charming, and besides the character, what helps him is the fact that he's really handsome and he has some economical resources, which make him really easy for him to target a lot of victims, and you know, he committed the abuse. Anna, for me, it's one of those victims that give him the major supply because of her, you know, personality that is very submissive, and that's what he likes about her. So, no further say, I would like to show you a few clips about, you know, the movies from this character, and you can tell there the dynamic they have that is really unhealthy. And remember, never accept that type of behavior from someone else, even a friend, a family member, a couple, anything. You cannot, you know, take that type of behavior as something that is normal, because it is not. It is toxic, it is unhealthy, and that leads to a lot of diseases when it comes to your emotional part. So, well, no further say, let's watch it, and then I'm going to be commenting about it.
Do you want to punish me right now?
Yes, I want to punish you right now.
What if I told you that I feel the same way about being punished as you do about me touching you? Would you still want to punish me then?
No. But that doesn't mean I wouldn't need to.
Why?
Anna, stop.
Why do you need to?
Because it's the way I am!
What I can tell here is that they having a really, really, really sick or very twisted relationship. First, because of he has been on contract with her, and for the ones that is very, you know, related to the movie that you have watched it, you can realize that this is not whatsoever normal. And the fact that she's asking him, "Are you going to hit me?" Like, come on, what kind of relationship is that? And I remember then, and this is not like completely there in the scene, that in the first book, the end of the book is like he hit her with a belt, I guess, because he was being, you know, dominant in the part, you know, in the intercourse, and she didn't like it and she left. And I guess that they're talking or referring to that, that she's not accepting that side of him, that he's really sick. And he's like yelling, he's getting a little bit upset about it, and I don't like the way he's communicating with her at that moment. And I know that we are not perfect, we tend to lose it, sometimes I do it as well, to be honest, but I have seen it like many parts of the movie that he raises his voice to her, and that's something that we cannot normalize, okay? We always need to control ourselves, and I know that's a big work that, in my opinion, I have to do. But this character tends to lose it a lot with her, and I don't find it really fair. And this is why I consider that he's really abusive. However, let's keep watching and let's keep commenting.
You take me to meet the woman who seduced and abused you.
Our relationship ended years ago. We're just friends and business partners.
Business partners? Are you kidding me? Would you take your subs there? Oh my God, for what? Her approval?
What?
What is this?
No, it's not like that.
That girl that I saw this morning was one of them, wasn't she?
Let's discuss this back at my place. I can have someone come by, do your hair.
Christian, I don't care about my hair.
Here, you can clearly see that there is a triangulation between him, this other lady, and Anna. And now, first, I would like to check a little bit what a triangulation is. Triangulation is when you create, let's imagine I am the one who is a manipulator, and I have in my other half a couple, I have my ex. And I start telling my couple, my current couple, that my ex is calling me, he is always like texting me and all the stuff, but I feel that he's not forgetting me and all the stuff, and he feels really worried about it because he's in love with me. He doesn't want to have someone else like chasing me, but I create this lie for him to worry and create control over him, because that makes me look very appealing towards him or in front of him. And maybe if I have communication with my ex-boyfriend, I can say that he is jealous of him, he's always talking about him, he's obsessed and all this stuff. So I create this triangulation, okay? And that gives the manipulator the power to show the victim that he is really appealing, and that you always need to be very careful about that. He does it in a way that he takes her, like, especially to the hair salon where that lady is. She feels really, like, Anna feels really insulted about it, and she has the right to be. Like, why you have to take me here? Exactly where she is. And he says, well, she's my partner. After what he told her about the fact that she was abusive to him, she was, I think, his first sexual experience, and Anna, of course, is not comfortable with it. But now he happens to be partner in the business with her, and he has a good relationship with her. So of course, that's a triangulation that is happening there. So he's putting Anna go through a lot of emotional stress, and that is not fair for that character. But that's why I'm saying that this character is not mentally healthy, and he needs that kind of like interaction in order maybe for him to feel the supply that he needs from her. So let's continue watching.
You're not happy about this baby. I got that. I'm not ecstatic either, given the timing and your reaction. But babies happen when you have sex, and you and I tend to do a lot of that. So we can either do this together, or I will do it without you.
And what about us?
Well, when your husband prefers the company of his ex-mistress, it doesn't really say much for your marriage, does it?
Elena and I just talked. I was too angry with you.
I'm angry with you, Christian! You left me! You left me when I needed you! You fucked up!
Yes, I fucked up, and I'm sorry. I'm standing here telling you I'm sorry. Okay, she doesn't mean anything to me. I don't need her. I need you.
Would have been good if you felt that way yesterday.
Okay, clearly here, they had a fight because he found out that she was pregnant and he didn't take it very well. And, you know, I know that maybe in some situations being pregnant, it is not a good idea because of economical problems and things like that. But I don't find it, like, I wouldn't find any justification, or I wouldn't justify, I think it is said like that, to someone that yell at you because you're pregnant. First of all, he had to realize that he was having a lot of intercourse with her, and, you know, there is a possibility from her to being pregnant. And the other thing is that he left, okay, he left her alone, and he went with his ex-girlfriend. How she could find out about it from the ones who hasn't watched the movie? She saw the cell phone, and she saw a message that was getting into when he arrived at home. And what he did first, and just to, you know, organize a little bit better my ideas, is that he made the silent treatment to her. Okay, and when he disappeared, after she said the news, she was being very vulnerable there. I'm pregnant, he yelled at her, and again, he did it. And then he left. That was really immature, and he disappeared. He didn't talk to her. That was the silent treatment. That is another way of manipulation. Then he appeared being very drunk, and then she saw the message of his ex-mistress, that is the one, the same lady that he was having the triangulation with in the second clip, where it's the same lady, she saw the message, okay? And she, of course, she felt really upset about it. And he was with her sharing this moment that, to me, I think is really personal. Shouldn't have happened. And the third thing that I see there is that is that he start having this not not taking responsibility from his action by saying like that didn't mean anything to me. I don't need her like I need you and stuff like that. That's a way of gaslighting as well, because he's not taking it seriously. He's completely seeing how affected she is about what happened because of these things that I already named that he did. And you know, I don't think that I would like to be in a relationship where I'm always in pain and I feel that I'm walking on eggshells because I don't know if what I'm going to do next is right or wrong. So that's for you to see, and I wanted before finishing to tell you that no matter how powerful someone can be, no matter how handsome, you know, good looking that person can be, you cannot accept or tolerate this type of behavior towards you. You have to feel, you know, love yourself to feel that you deserve a love where you are respected, you are valued. And that's why it is so important just to work in your self-esteem before even moving forward and looking for someone else to have a relationship with. Because if you don't make a really strong foundation about building self-love, then you're going to be very, you know, a good target for someone to abuse you. And that's not the type of relationship anyone wants, because it's going to be more pain than actual love. So if you like the video, you can subscribe. And like I always say, I do this with all my love. And remember, self-love is key in order for you to have real love from someone else in a relationship.